Backyard Brains brings you a new experiment demonstrating principles of neuroprosthetics. We thank the students of Clarkston High School for suggesting this to us. Specifically, we'll use the neuronal output of one leg to control the muscle activity in another leg. To begin, retrieve two cockroach legs and plug your spiker box into one of the legs. Now we're going to take a Y splitter and plug it into our spiker box. One half of the Y splitter will go into a secondary speaker so that we can still hear the spikes while we're doing our experiment. Now, for reasons that are still strange to me, we cannot directly hook up the spiker box to the secondary cockroach leg. The spiker box can only output about 1 volt max, and we need to increase it to about 2 volts before we can elicit muscle movement. Therefore, the other half of the Y splitter is going to a secondary amplifier that is then outputting to our stimulation cable that is plugged into needles placed into the secondary cockroach leg. Now, the secondary amplifier is capable of generating up to 6 or 7 volts, so we don't need the amplifier up all the way. I'm going to turn it up just a bit to where the cockroach leg starts spontaneously moving, and then I'm going to lower the volume just below that threshold. Now watch what happens as I elicit more spikes by brushing the primary leg. This preparation is wide open to experimentation. For example, how precise were the movements? Did specific spike patterns elicit accompanying specific movements? We're excited to hear what you come up with. Backyard Brains, neuroscience for everyone.